is at his soon return. The church is sitting around belly aching, sitting around murmuring. You got some preachers preaching mid-trib. You got some preachers preaching post-trib. And the church doesn't know when Jesus is coming. And we don't know, no man knows. But I'm here to tell you, I don't believe in mid-trib. I don't believe in post-trib. But I believe in pre-trib. Because you preach mid-trib or post-trib, you are still in people's hope. You hear what I'm saying? Because Titus chapter 2 verse 11 says, the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared unto all men, teaching us to deny ungodliness and worldly lusts. We should live righteously, amen, soberly, godly, amen, and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope and that glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What's your hope tonight, Brother Vogan? My hope that he'll split them eastern skies. I've got nothing that, amen, draws me back to that Parsons 2, that I just gotta get there. Come tonight, Lord, and the spirit and the bride cry, come. But if he don't come tonight, I'm gonna wake up in the morning and say, Lord, this may be the day that you come today. This may be the cloud that you come back on. It's my hope. And don't you let the devil pull your anchor up. You drop your anchor down. Say, devil, I'm not moving. I'm not swaying at the promises of God. But it's the anchor of my soul. It's my hope. And John said it this way. We do not what, amen, know what shall appear, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. And everyone that has his hope within himself purifies himself even as he is pure. But you know why there's no righteous living tonight? You know why there's no holy living tonight? You know why there's no clean living tonight? Because people have lost that hope of his appearance. But if you really have an expectation of him coming, you're going to keep your life clean. You're going to keep your closet clean. You're going to keep your eye clean, your heart clean, everything around you clean. Why? Because he may come, and friend, he's going to yank the cover off everyone's life. And all's going to be beseen. I don't know about you, but I want to keep my life hid in the blood of Christ, because I've got too many faults. I've got too many shortcomings. And when the God, I need to be wrapped up and tied up in the blood of Jesus, and my trust and my confidence is in him, and I'm hoping for his coming while you live the way you live, because he could come tonight, and I don't want to be left behind. While you're praying, amen, into God, seeking the Lord, because I want to be praying when he comes. I don't want to be a slothful servant. I don't want to be, amen, to God, beating my servant and not drunkard, but I want to be about my Father's service, because he could come on, amen, tonight, and are we ready?
Come on, yeah.
Amen. Let's all stand.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
It's my anchor.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hope is the anchor of our soul.
Wrong.
You can tell those who get steadfast in the church, they're not up and down and in and out. They got their anchor down.
Come on.
It's not so deep that God can't move you, but it's deep enough, devil, you sure can't move it.
Come on.
Come on.
Yeah.
Glory.
It's all right to sing the song, I shall not be moved, I shall not be moved, if we're in the right place.
That's right. Come on.
Oh God, give me an expectation like I've never known. And church, if we be honest with ourselves, we come through them doors, we ain't expecting nothing to happen.
Come on.
Just another church service. Just another Wednesday night. Hey, Mr. God. Got up, come over here, pray, didn't have nothing to preach. I'm glad some of the preachers can put on a sign while they're preaching 2 weeks in advance. I guess they hear from God better than I do. Come back from the funeral, didn't know what to preach. I just stopped and sat there on my desk. Said, Lord, I want to hear from God. I just don't want to bring a message, because if it's not your will, it's going to be a dead letter. Right. Something stirred in me, hope, the anchor of your soul.
Mom.
And when he said your soul, my soul, it's your anchor.
Our soul.
Got looking at that word of God, hope, the anchor of the soul. It's an anchor that you've got to keep down, solid. Don't you leave this church, and don't you leave the Lord Jesus Christ and his love. You get a hope and expectation in him again, and set your anchor down. Say, devil, I shall not be moved. This is my territory God gave me, and I'm not giving up no ground. And more than that, Lord, I want you to enlarge my coast and give me more ground. Amen. Thank God for what you've done in my soul, but I claim my children's soul. Amen. I'm dropping anchor down in their room. I'm anointing their room. I'm praying for them every time they come in here, Lord, and turn on that jig-a-boo music and that country music, convict their lives. Every time they put in that old junk music, convict them and save them. Amen. I pray the Holy Ghost get a hold of them. I'm setting my anchor down right here that you would save their lost soul.
Amen.
You got hope tonight?
Oh, yeah.
A lot of things can happen to try to steal your hope. Doctor said you only got 2 months to live. But you know what? I'm not leaving this world till God's done with me.
Amen.
That's right.
At this point, Brother Blakely, I'm still a step ahead of death.
Yes.
That's right.
I don't know how many steps I am ahead, but I'll stay ahead as long as God wants me to stay ahead.
Come on.
Don't lose your expectation tonight. I want us to come in here so excited about serving God that we just can't help. I know we may be tired of body, but just can't help to get to our feet every now and then. And lift our hands and God, I believe in you for what I've been praying for. I mean, I'd love to see that enthusiasm just keep pumping and getting strong. And I promise you,
come on.
We can come in and sit down not thinking nothing's going to happen. We have lost our hope.
Come on. Amen.
Give me hope, Lord, that help me to believe and to expect it to come to pass.
Oh, yes, Jesus.
Glory to
God. Amen, amen.
Because I don't hope in this world or hope in man, but I've got my faith and my hope in the Lord. And when you put your faith and your hope and your expectation in Him, He'll never let you down. He swear by no greater than Himself, because He cannot lie. I don't can't swear. I can't change one jot, one tittle of my body. I can't change my stature. I can't change nothing. But God can swear by Himself that He can do anything He wants to.
That's right.
Praise God. I want us to come to these altars this evening. I want us to pray and ask God to give us an expectation like we've never had before. That's been my prayer.